Macfarlane, please welcome to the stage of us for leaving, Celine! Put your hands together, guys, and make some noise!
Hello, Glasgow!
I am so lucky to be collaborating with my not only a lovely friend, but the lady who makes this place happen, Dawn Izatt.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. I would just like to say this has been a long time in coming. For those of you who don't know, Celine's Salon was meant to come to Glasgow before lockdown happened, and then she was meant to come again when the lockdown got lifted, and then we went back into lockdown. So it's an absolute pleasure to have her here, and also to have her friends who've travelled from London and other parts of the UK. Thank you all so much for coming tonight.
Yeah, I just want to say, can we just give another massive round of applause for accommodating us? Aww. We really appreciate it.
I'm really here, okay?
I'm also going to start the show tonight is dedicated to, a few of us know, to Jake Black, whose birthday was a couple of days ago. Let's give a big one for Jake! Yes! Yeah. So, Celine Salon has been going for 6 years. And it's always been a dream to get out of London and collaborate with other places. We're also very privileged to have Frank Rafferty here, all the way from Derry, from Bluebell Arts, and Rachel, who've helped start the island. You know, it's fantastic. And next we've got Wales. So out of this, we're putting a book together, all of us, Frank, Dawn, and it's a Celtic collection of all the people that perform within that book. It's an anthology. We did volume one, which had 29 writers from all over the world. And we're very lucky, Joe Dark's in the room, Tom McColl, Lucy George, who set up Wordville Press, has been fantastic in publishing works in performing arts. So, Lucy, that you're here in spirit. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here today because she's jetting off somewhere probably and getting like pissed. Thanks, Lucy, you cheeky moo. So, our theme tonight is heroes. So, for me, a hero doesn't have to be a famous hero. It can be an unsung hero. So, I actually wrote this at 7 o'clock this morning in the place we're staying over the road, and it's called My Husband is My Hero. My husband is my hero. He earns an honest bob. He treats me like a queen and paid for my nose job. You never hear him moan, comes home every night. But who'd have ever thought his fetish for Marmite? He spreads it on his ears, he spreads it on his toes, he stirs it in his beer and wipes it on his clothes. He rubs it in his hair, that sticky horrid mess, and so I do declare I'm feeling very stressed. Oi, you bastard, get that fucking Marmite off the wall, I'll throw this crumb on you. I've told you about this, now bugger off. My husband is a snorer, and me, maybe a little, but he's a proper roarer. My bones are turning brittle. He bellows out from his chest, it rolls from his top lip, and then to top it off, I still can't get no kip. From clips on his nose, to rolling him on his side, oils with Indian rose, just leave me bleary-eyed. Oh Lord, just let me sleep, where is the gaffer tape? My love, don't make me weep, I need a quick escape. I told you last stop. The bloody duvet's hitting the ceiling, me bum's hit the light bulb. Cheers, mate. My husband is a grafter, he buys me lovely frocks, but gone is the laughter when I'm picking up his socks. He rolls them in a ball, he leaves them in the loo. I found them in the pool and even in me stew, floating in our fish tank, one in a biscuit tin, two in the fruit and veg, and another in a wheelie bin. Now I'm too young for a casket, my patience has worn thin, just stick them in the laundry basket, it really ain't a sin. I told you, you little bug, if I find another one of these, I'm going to shove them right out, I'm going to shove them, you bet. Oh, my husband is my hero. My husband is my joy. My husband is not fearful. He's still my cheeky boy. Yes, my husband is my hero. And yes, I love him so. But if you don't pick your socks up, I'm telling you to go. Thank you. Gary, you're meant to be laughing. Anyway, let's kick the night off with the wonderfully talented slam poet extraordinaire, Katherine Macfarlane.
Thank you so much, Celine. And after that wonderful upbeat start, I'm going to bring it right back down again because I'm a slam poet. I'm sorry. Are you scared of dying? I'm sorry, look, I know it's Friday night. That's not the kind of question you slide down the bar between pints. It's just that lately all the talk has been so small or crammed full of chemical details, and I don't really understand it all. And there are so many questions, but they're all just different shades of scared. And we should have been more prepared. This is the conversation we haven't dared have yet. And we're not just musing hypothetically on life's fragility or our own mortality. This time, it's real. And I really don't know how you feel. I mean, when you close your eyes and think of death, is it some big guy all in black, maybe on horseback? Or is death already part of your life? A blessed relief, like a warm breeze on a beach or a friend walking beside you, but just out of reach. God, I sound like a Hallmark card. I knew this was going to be hard. I've watched you fighting it. Calm as the needle sinks in, breathing through radiation, joking you always knew you needed therapy, just hadn't imagined it would be the chemo variety. Are you scared? That question asked so many times before. Exam scared, first date scared, end of the aisle scared, labour ward scared. Are you scared? And you were always far more prepared. Had a book or the right words for it, but what book do I get you now? The Art of Dying? The Final Words, or simply one on how not to cry? Because we've come too far now together to cry uncle, too far to cry at all. And we both learned when we were small that crying doesn't fix anything at all. And I don't need tears to see what it hurts. Your scars say it all. You're scarred but not scared. We have all seen your strength, seen your dignity, unafraid of your own fragility. You have been everything I know I could never be. But tell me, are you scared? Because I am terrified. Terrified we're out tonight together for the last time. Terrified to sleep, too scared to sleep, too scared to eat, too scared to leave your side. I am terrified. Knowing death will come calling and you'll ask me to keep breathing. Breathe in. Breathe in. Without you, I am panicking. Breathe in, breathe in. Look, it's Friday night, and this Friday night starts out like every Friday night before. Clothes scattered all over the floor, nothing quite right for what just might be the best night of your life, or at least this week's highlight. So you're stripped bare, but you don't care because you're contoured to the max, lipstick from an ad that promises that the exact right shade of red will turn something dull and boring into something bold and interesting. And this night you are sure you have got the exact right shade of red, so you've downed a bottle of it just in case. You slide on something short and tight. It is Friday night. Slide on siren high heels, feeling 10 feet tall, feet hurting like hell. You stagger to the nearest bar, down a Bacardi breezer or something even sweeter to swill out that strange taste of displacement, and still it lingers. So the drinks get shorter, shot after shot, and still you've not quite got it, that easy, breezy, beautiful, still more kind of shy, scared, resentful of those Friday night good timers who seem to find it all just so damn easy. Another drink should ease you into it. that the drinks get shorter and small talk makes you smaller until exhausted you shrink in on yourself. Absent yourself, drinking absinthe by yourself and like some post-Brexit Briton, casting around desperately for a last-minute trade deal, you settle for something more than a little disappointing. And he's breathing beer in your face, muttering something about your place, and the lines on his shirt are moving, and so is his mouth, but you can't hear what he's saying until suddenly you're watching from above in slow motion and you're vomiting on his really, really shiny shoes. And nobody moves. Then he's calling you a cow, and so is this blonde girl now. I think someone spilled her drink. I don't see how that's my problem. Stagger, heavy breathing to the bathroom, forehead cool against the mirror. Redo your eyeliner. Contouring looks shite in here. It must just be the light in here. And scrawl a question mark on the mirror in exactly the right shade of red. Half wish I was dead. And this girl's worrying, some other girl's giggling, and this big guy saying, "Oh, hen, I think it's time you were leaving." And you're out on the street in the cold on your knees, Bacardi Breezer in reverse, and I don't remember the rest. Wake up next morning, stomach heaving, tongue cleaves to the roof of Saturday. Breathe in, breathe in. Keep the vomit in, breathe in, breathe in. Don't dare look at my phone, I've got no idea how I got home. Breathe in, breathe in. These bruises on my skin, I don't understand the story they're telling. Breathe in, breathe in. And I want to ink respect into my skin, but I've heard that respect only comes from within. Breathe in, breathe in. Why do we have to break just to try to fit in? Breathe in, breathe. Breathe in, go back to the beginning. Breathe in, ink love into your skin. Let it slowly sink in that you were loved from the very beginning. Breathe in, loved even like this, loved even this mess. Breathe in, breathe out, keep breathing. Thank you. Thank you so much. That was one of my very special heroes. In fact, there's lots of heroes in that poem. There's all those people that pick you up from the bathroom floor, those friends that put you in a taxi and get you home that you can't remember. So lots of heroes in that one. This next one's still keeping that theme of breathing going. But so sometimes you need to be your own hero. I have climbed a mountain that started as a path amongst trees taller than any I have known, until scrambling, bleeding over rocks, I faced the final cliff laced with chain. Hands sliding on each link, I pulled upwards and landed. Feet firm on top of the other side of the world, gazing seawards, where once men and ships stared back and called this place warning. I have ridden the waves and swum deep beneath the ocean, and it has owned me, each heaving mass throwing me to the floor, showing me I am stronger than the broken shells scattered by the wave that went before. I have fought with the sea until learning, gazed skywards and went gently to the shore. I have slept a summer by the smallest waterfall, diamond-decked waters tumbling under the dizzying spell of dragonflies and the soft, sweet song of bees. It was there the sun kissed me and dressed me in freckles, so I'd remember that childhood is everywhere and summer in each day. I have lain helpless with laughter in the snow, two tiny bodies warm atop me, hollowed out angels each side, gazing heavenwards, counting stars and howling at what was left of the moon, until ghosts crowding close and muscles burning, I pulled a sledge full of my own blood homewards, singing to keep the darkness at bay. I have lived in the spaces between each breath. Thank you.
Thank
Thank you very much. And I'm going to finish with one tonight from... It still doesn't come naturally, because this is the book that came out during lockdown, so I haven't waved it around a lot. I'm going to finish with one from here called... Well, in the book it's called Seven for a Secret, but in my notebook it's called Lies. My father said, let sleeping dogs lie. Lies. From the cliff edge, like black sheep in wolves' clothing, howling and warning in the face of the mindless, the whitewashed, the woolly who bleat in time to the party line, flock from mall to movie, tabloid to BBC, grazing endlessly on a diet of dissatisfaction in the pursuit of perfection, that type of perfection that can only be bought, the type of perfection that serves as a distraction from distorted reflection of 24 hour of world without hope. A single black and white bird, one for sorrow tonight, tomorrow, on 24-hour repeat, we stand and bleat at a single black and white bird, shiver in the downdraft of fear from her wings like magpies. Distract ourselves with shiny things, yet here is the seven the flock has forgotten. Here is the secret we must never be told. The secret is no secret. It is there in the stories of old, dismissed as superstition, but which once danced from generation to generation, tongue to tongue, brought alive by the fireside. The secret is no secret. Look again at your plumage. The black and white is the lie. They see that unfettered by fear, you would be eager for the sky, and there is no need to teach an eagle how to fly, not with a wind of change on your wings. But it's when I speak of these things that dear old auntie says, do not rock the boat. Do you not understand? You can drown within sight of shore. And I find myself clutching at straws, always uncertain, always unsure. I mean, sure, I understand the science of drowning. Blood thinning, oxygen diminishing, lungs filling, heartbeat stopping. But can you drown in just rain? Can you drown in the slow drip, drip of other people's pain? My mother says, least said, soonest mended. But I don't want to mend this. I want to pick it apart at the seams, unpick stitched lips, hear the silence scream their stories, our stories of colony and power and blood and war and family and shame and sorry. We have been so busy killing a man in the sky with science that we learned only to think in black and white, forgot that we know the secret of flight, that we are the one and the two for joy, and together we are bold. This is a secret we must never be told. My grandmother is crying for the baby that lies dying, thrown out with bathwater gone cold. But I smile at my daughter.
Thank you so much, Celine, and thank you everybody for having me. Wow, that was wonderful. Thank you so much, Katherine Macfarlane. Yes, and she, I know a few people here have commitments, and I really appreciate that you made so much effort. I want to be, yeah, let's do more, please. Talking. Thank you, Katherine Macfarlane. Well done. Also, we've had to, Marie, I've swapped you with Keith because he also has a commitment, so I do apologise. This man has credits all the way down his arm with acting, music, film. I've checked you out. And we're not going to say too much, but I just want you to give a lovely, warm welcome to Keith Warwick.
Thanks very much. Fucking hell. I'm going to, because I've got a chair here. Not that I'm so old that I need a chair, but my memory's definitely going because I forgot my guitar strap. So, bear with me while I fuck about with my technical issues. Now. Brilliant, I just get my beer here. Okay, so. Thanks very much. The name's Keith. And the subject being heroes, it's pretty easy for me, really. It's my dad. So, working class hero, three masters, all with distinction. And, you know, he said to me, always, you know, as a kid, the only way for the working class to drag themselves out of the mire is through education. Unfortunately, my dad has Alzheimer's now. So, I go round and I see him on a Wednesday night and I play the guitar for him. And sometimes you've got to judge it, you know, so if I'm playing a Springsteen song or whatever and he becomes distracted, I go, right, okay, we're not in the 70s. So I'll try Elvis, and he'll spark up. Oh, Elvis, fucking Elvis. I'm like, right, we're in the 50s. So I've got a wee collection. As you can see, I've written my set list on my arm. So I'm only going to do four or five songs. But the first one being, it's an Arthur Alexander song called Anna. Now, one of my sisters is called Anna. And he doesn't know who she is, but he likes the song. So if you just bear with me while I play the songs that my dad likes, then it's a great way for me to get round this idea of heroes and hitting those marks all the time. Okay, so Anna.
Ask me, girl, to set you free, girl. He say he loves you more than me, so I will set you free. Go with him, Anna. Go with him, Anna, Anna. Girl, before you go now, I want you to know now, I still love you so, but if he loves you more, go with him. All of my life, I've been searching for a girl to love me like I love you. Let me tell you now, every girl I've ever had breaks my heart and leaves me sad. Well, what am I supposed to do? Oh, Anna, just one more thing, girl. You give back your ring to me, then I will set you free. With him, Anna, go with him. You can go with him, girl.
Right, I'll tune up this time. Thanks very much. This isn't even my guitar. It's got a tuner in it and everything's mental. The guitar I use at my dad's is like, my pal Davey gave it to me, and it's like, yeah, it's like, it's, I said I need a guitar to take to my dad's, and it's like, you know, if you play the guitar and you get your first guitar, the neck is always like, you'd need, you know, you'd need like hands, like shovels. So it's kind of that other guitar's kind of similar. This is a luxury. Right, what have I got? So this next song kind of livens him up a wee bit. It's an old country song by, I think it was Jess Records, 55, something like that. A guy called Eddie Fontaine. Please bear with me.
What love is all about. Every single day when school gets out, see my baby, I said we kept the bees. Did nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. If I should be such a doggone tease. Nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. We meet the gang and I go to Rockin' Judge. Cats are jumping on the heels and their toes. See my baby try to give her a squeeze. And nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. Well, she knocked my heart and threw away the keys. Ain't nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. She's got a way that makes me act like a fool. She spends my money and lets her please me. I'm begging for kisses on my bended knees. Won't you give me some loving, baby? Please, 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 please. One day the wind will blow, the sun will shine. Till the day, baby, you will be mine. Still I gotta keep my heart at ease. Ain't nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. Watch that, rock my heart and throw away the key. Ain't nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. Ain't nothing shaking but the leaves on the trees. Thank you. So, it's kind of weird, I played that one for him on Wednesday and he was fucking laughing all the way through it. I was going, what is so amusing here? I mean, it's sometimes with my dad, you know, I think he thinks I'm just a carer that plays the guitar and makes his dinner. And I'm like, that's, see that picture there? Who's that? And it's very obviously me. And he'll go, me. And I'm like, that's me. And I found another photo and it kind of, similar to the other one, but not quite as cool. And I says, oh, I suppose that's you as well. And he went, that's almost me. And I thought, that's a fair point, you've got me. And I tell you, he's forever getting me on technicalities. I was walking across the road with him, there's loads of traffic, his wife's called Linda. And so I've taken his hand, and I'm going, Christ, this road's really busy. And I was thinking, I better warn him, you know. I says, you never cross the road, you know, without holding Linda or I's hand, and he without Linda or I, and he went, or me. And I was like, that fucking great eye, or you, of course. So what I'll do is I'll play a wee song. I mean, he used to know the words to things. It's funny, you know, like he would know all the words to Del Sharon's Runaway, but he doesn't know my name. And I'm like, fucking hell, the amount of times I've left that house nearly greeting. But the thing is, he's happy, you know. He's not overly anxious or anything. He's, you know, anyway. So he no longer sings along. He does this sort of inward eerie whistle. You have to find the positives. So this is a Tommy Tucker song. So again, it's just a bit of rhythm and blues. I'll try that again. Toby Tucker's like, that's not my song. I'll put on your red dress, baby. I'll put that wicked on your head. Put on your red dress, baby. Pretty sure you're gonna knock 'em down. Put on your high heel sneakers. Put a wheel on you. Put on your high heel sneakers. 'Cause you're going out tonight. Wash the box and gloves. Okay, some fool might wanna fight. We tribute here. Solo by Graham Warwick. Put on your red dress, baby. 'Cause we're going out tonight. Put on your red chase some fool man wanna fight.
Thank you very much. So well, dudes, I'll finish you off with this next absolute cracker of a song. Again, it's about, you know, everybody's dad or their mum are the heroes in your family. Sometimes it's not just about, you know, he played for Partick Thistle and Wolves briefly, he was in junior football all over the place, won everything. Same my grandpa, he won the amateur cup and he was with Govan Emerald, and my wee brothers was with Dundee United and Arsenal. Now, I've spent my career mincing about the boards for a living, and I genuinely think that I'm a monumental fucking disappointment to the football legacy of my family. However, that aside, sometimes it's not about your achievements, you know, that you can have a bit of paper that says that you've completed a succession of tests and that you're qualified to do something. And he certainly has plenty of them. For me, it's about the time that your parents spend with you, you know, from when you're a wee kid, straight through your adolescence, into your adulthood. It's about the, and I try to do it with my own wee girl Clyde, is just spending that quality time. Now, whether it's just cuddling up and watching a movie or, you know, cooking together or dancing or whatever, it's just that quality time. So this is my last song for the hero that is my dad, this is about, this gives you a real indication of what age I am, by the way. As you can tell, I'm a real fan, I've been out of tune. I wish I was a spaceman, the fastest guy alive. I'd fly you round the universe on Fireball XL5. Way out in space together, conquerors of the sky. My heart would be a fireball, a fireball, a fireball, and you would be my Venus. Venus, you would be my Venus of the stars. Thanks very much. Have a wonderful evening.
The track now. Hello, Peter, huh? C'est pas vrai, monsieur.
Let's get this bugger up. Right, hold on. Come on. No? Oh, it's a bit tight. There we go. Got it. Yeah, you know that. I know I'm short, but don't take the mickey out of me, all right? And I'm half French. English, Irish, French. French for the jealousy. English, no, sorry. French for the jealousy, Irish for the guilt, and English for a feather up my arse. I don't know where that came from, but hey-ho. Anyway, moving on swiftly. We held, during lockdown, we really tried to keep the torch burning with the salon and help people have something, a go-to creatively. So we created a digital platform where we put Celine's salon on YouTube. And we also had workshops where we taught writers how to write comic monologues. And we've got two of the participants here, I shouldn't say part of the writers, and the next lady that's coming up, it's so beautiful to see her flourish as a writer, as a performer. She's an individual comic genius in her own right, and all I'm going to say is watch this space in the future. Without further ado, do you do the voodoo that I do? Maria Mas.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Wonders Waxing Salon, Westminster's premier waxing salon, to the Tory party man to speak, and how can I help? Oh, hello, Mr. Johnson. Well, you'd like an appointment, would you? Got another party coming up, have you? Legal one this time. Will it be then your usual landing strip? Oh. Going for a full back sack and crack this time, are we? Is that because you ain't got anyone landing on your strip no more? So, oh no, I was just joking, Mr. Johnson. I'm sure you've got plenty of jumbo jets queuing to get up your runway. If they can find it, eh? Mr. Johnson, no, I didn't say if they can find it. I said if they can fund it, because we all know you're very expensive, very exclusive, and you don't just let anyone up there, do ya? Yeah. Anyway, enough talking about your balls, Mr. Johnson. I think you best get back to ballsing up. I mean, running the country, hadn't you? Yes. So shall we... Shall we put you in your normal slot, shall we? 2 o'clock on Tuesday. Lovely. All right, got you in there. All right, Mr. Johnson, so we'll see you next Tuesday then, won't we? Yeah. TTFN. All right. God. It's a thankless job, this is. Tell you what, though. I wasn't always destined to be a receptionist in a waxing salon to the Tory party. No, I believe that I was destined for greater things. I keep having visions that I was once a great warrior queen, driving my chariot into battle, my flame hair flowing in the wind behind me, a great vast army advancing, 6 great stallions ahead of me. That's right. Ladies and gents, I believe that I, Mandy from Dagenham, was once Boudica, Queen of the Iceni, Avenger of the Ancient Celts, Scourge of the Romans, the greatest warrior to ever have lived!
Take over our lands. I'm ready to go where them Romans let's go and take them down in their fancy theatres. Take back everything that they, what's that word again? Oh yeah, stole. So let's begin. I won't give in. I know this battle I've got to win. And then we'll be finally free and part of this world.
Back to the real world, I suppose. Wow.
Hang on, got to get my coat back on.
It's not over yet, Celine.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God.
Sorry.
The phone's ringing again.
Oh, here we fucking go again. Oh, who is it this time? Hello, Wonders Waxing Salon, Westminster's premier waxing salon to the Tory party. Mandy speaking, how can I help? Oh, hello, Mr. Sumac. Oh, you'd like an appointment, would you? Oh, you're going to the same party as Boris again. what'll it be this time then? Anal bleach, as usual. Oh, you'd like a reputation bleach? Oh, now, that will be a bit more expensive and will take a bit more time. You might have to fork out a bit more for that one, but you probably got a bit of money there, you know, from your wife and that tax you didn't pay. Yeah. All right, lovely. You're all right with that? Okay, so shall we book you in your usual slot as well? On Tuesday, yeah, I've got an opening at, 4 o'clock. Can you make that? Lovely. Rishi Sunak. There we go. Reputation bleach. All right. Lovely. So I'll see you next Tuesday as well, Mr. Sunak. Lovely. Thank you. TTFN.
Maria Maz, I'm sorry I did that, Maria. That was
right.
I didn't know the. What? Isn't she brilliant? And it's like seeing her go from there all the way up to there is like astounding. All right. Give me another 50 quid, love, and I'll butter you up more, all right? Oh, my son. I feel like a bit of a gangster's wife in here tonight.
You are.
Oh, yes, darling, I fucking feel like a gangster. I feel like I want to get in that cage, and I'll stick my husband in there and smother him in chocolate, the dirty old bastard. 20 years I've been married to him. I'll tell you what, we were really poor when I was a kid. A cabbage was like a football. A fart was like an air freshener. But I never grumbled. That's right. Because we all buckle down and we sing a song. I'm a smelly old cow. I'm a smelly old cow. Don't even try and think. Because I do love to stink. Right. Very last minute beautiful guest. I was very privileged to be on his show. Radio interview online. Thank you. I'm not going to go into it. I just want to give you a really lovely warm welcome to Mark McGee.
I'm only here because someone else is a sore ear. The last year appeared to be filled with fake news, paid views, deep fakes. Every film I seen on my computer screen seemed to be remakes. I gained weight by being chained to a chair in the name of entertainment, played the blame game with the rest of them as Ken Sculpture gained a facelift. At one point, the lockdown bakers had the place eating my. At one point, the lockdown bakers had the place eating my body weight and steak bakes and make do with microwave and microchips. Every time I saw that Bill Gates face, and I think we all learned that everyone's an expert these days. Well, apart from doctors, nurses, or the experts, obviously. There was winners and losers, and yes, beggars can be choosers. I self-isolated myself till they opened up the bruisers. With the caveat for me that background music should be booming. Every Zoom call was confusing, just another muted human. This city's always grim, but this one was different. The youth were by quick still, yet they dragged it every minute. The critical thinking definition of cynic means now everyone's a skeptic, but their heart's not really in it. It's more question everything. It's question everything! Except the sources that I parrot. Friendships end up damaged because lines and sand became apparent. And the Brexit in the rear view, the worst of two wrongs. The past and tax dodge for Boris is another cue formed. From months to months, we marched in packs. We roamed in tribes, took sides and chose our facts. At the point when my whole planet is slowly falling apart, high five my dad through the glass. It all happened so fast. What is heroes? What are heroes? This isn't a bit, I'm just generally thinking out loud because I didn't know there was a theme. But we're dedicated to my dad who passed away last month. He mentioned that song. Shout out to my dad! Shout out! Bad father, but great cunt to get wasted with. Good mate, you know. And on that subject, Jake Black, shouts to Jake Black, it's his birthday! Another amazing cunt. And yeah, shouts to Jake. And yeah, I'm going to do something a wee bit more upbeat. Fucking legend on Mikey, shouts to Mikey on the sound desk. Can we cue up fun as we know? So this is fun as we know, Lord. So I'm just going to do a bit of material that's... I made an album under the name Jackal Trades last year called At This Point. And it's already out of date, so... Just pretend you're still locked down. This is called Fun Has Been Outlawed. I've been dumped with promoters and ignored by the putters, punched by the benches caused by the mischief of others. And the barmy board bargained me another starving artist. The man that owned this continent saw the last man standing. I'm a slate, night taxes and guest list passes. Sometimes I wonder with those rosy tinted glasses. I miss the stage craft and backstage banner. But it's hard to make cash when you're having after parties, cause I exist in a niche within another niche where the only paying customers are undercover police. What a daft career within the fans can't see past. A Scottish accent, yeah, they want you to be real. But what a day of disappear, let's see facts appear. All again, no one might appear desperate. I enjoy annoying critics who never even check that email on their desk. Jackal Trades with a press pack. Fun has been outlawed, but we can still work for now. There was a brief part of March where the roads were calm. There's no open mics or studios but plenty traffic jams. I'll feel lonely, wonder where they are going. Can I be camping cause it's no stop snowing? I hear neighbours and strangers are you on the street steaming. Suppose that's a sign that nature is healing. My Euro tour is over, cancelled all flights to Hanover. More human right, is it COVID or a hangover? Everything we worked for vanished overnight. The decimated nightlife is robbing still shit. Everything's more difficult, confused but right. Forgot my mask, I can't buy them without going inside. But I'm stuck outside, it's a vicious cycle. So got on my bike, raging sheep, my fist at the night, falling viable. For a fair store, people in a hotel, my secret's two shopkeepers or a seagull. Fun has been outlawed, but we can still work for nought. Fun has been outlawed, but we can still walk about. If we stay within our radius and don't take the piss. If we stay within our radius and don't take the piss. Stay within our radius and don't take the piss. Stay within our radius and don't take the... So my name's Mark, I'm on a podcast called You Call That Radio. Thanks to Celine for asking us. If you check it out, she was interviewed on it a couple of days ago. And this song's about how I imagined my band, the Gyro Babies. I went on stage and I was the generic hype man for Loki. I don't know if you're the Loki, but I was a generic hype man. And I went on stage and I pretended that I was opening up. It was the Scottish Album of the Year Awards. And I pretended that my band won it and opened an envelope. And then it kind of came back to bite me in the arse because someone went, I heard that you've got nominated for Scottish Album of the Year. And I was like, oh, did they? But it's not, it's just because I told a lie. And then this song's about that. It's about pretending that you won Scottish Album of the Year. So many people have heard this song that they do think that I won Scottish Album of the Year. Shh, I never. Like, dedicating seven of these one Scottish Album of the Year. Really? What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I just won Scottish Album of the Year. What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I just won Scottish Album of the Year. What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I just won Scottish Album of the Year. What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? Just like, so where I won my summer, Rookie won the Oour, Jerry Cinnamon won the fucking lottery. Oh well, I think young fathers won everything else. The World Cup, Eurovision and another Nobel Prize. Cabaret stole my banner, had that a stupid bar in my face from 10 years ago, the lovely lucky bastard. I won the Jimmy ordered me a pint, but the doorman, when they went me back inside, I've already been in, let me finish my beer. And I just won Scottish Album of the Year. What do you mean you don't mean it? You stole my idea. I just won Scottish Album of the Year. What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I just won. What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I just 30 years ago today the Beatles made the White Album. Last year I admit I might have made a shite album. Got no label, no funding, no press, no fun. Been making something out of nothing. This a miracle of fortune. Only time Tadler Dreamy of paparazzi show me. It's a fair way there, it's just a death. Question what they seen from the last LP. What's a problem? As in problematic, I somehow accidentally use my own accent. Scottish kids can't be a win to make an asthmatic. But for media I can add a wee trad bit. I can be tweeting you, I would never leave you, cause my postcode is G2. Choose what's your piece and choose. I'm more DIY than my B&Q. One day I'll maybe learn to fill out a form, then peekaboo. On that day I'll be seeing you. Come on, let you in the wee club. How can I be drunk? I played the bar with Don Room, they may help the naked. Three times. Okay, the fourth time getting cancelled because of lack of interest, but you know. Lack of tickets is round the fourth time. I'm going to do the chorus one more time. Ready? What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? What do you mean I'm too drunk to finish my beer? I don't know. You've won it as much as I did, every single one is. How many have I got? One, two?
Two more.
Okay. Yeah. That soundtrack stays, let's go for that. So the arc on the vocals, we'll see later on. Kids are not going to be. Dedicated to all your heroes. Rhythms and patterns and vocals from Saturn and the campfire crackles, cancer, right, bathroom, traps off the latch. Calm down, I'll catch a bad one, nuclear button react. Due to the sound of a cap gun, I'm ugly. I am handsome, skinny fat bastard, nothing buffers on this bandwidth. Laughing at how, laughing scrambled the language. It used to mean a problem, now it means you're shit at dancing. Insecure cycles, things that pull out of the giggle. Now I shut my eyes, I'm sleep walking down the aisle with little breathless and beats. So we're overriding wisdom, make the shy guys off the seat. When the feet fall in drifting, so we have to admit that the spark is existent. Coming through the system, replication from the system. Overusing serotonin, no, it's a bit different. Moderation is the key, but the rock's still fitting me. Pitting, laugh, pitting. I picked a winning horse from a squat party in Brixton. I see my dead friends Dr. Ganner in a lift room that helped him on the way to this funeral. For what made me think different. My brother saved my life. I was drowning at the deep end. He thought that I was screaming cause the water was too freezing. He could barely swim himself, but he dived in to get me gone. Bless the atheist for helping me. Nah, it's setting. I felt that drifting on a shipwreck melee. The scene goes fuzzy with an orderly. Ness's wife flashes as the waves crash down in these verses. The bless as the storm lasts shows no mercy. It's hard to explain, but it stays with me for decades. Our last confession is the type for verses, but it's mad and forgiving. Some will get to forget you. Go for them with the way, and all them want to hurt you. They will cut me where I'm building to avoid a mention of you. But the powers and the choosing me, whether that upsets you, I was saved that night with an act of brilliance. That won't happen every day, yeah. Even if it kills you, we'd pick them. Well, I've picked them, but I'm an easy taking blame or credit for decisions. 99% is instinct. Look, it's all been determined words and songs from the spirit that we're always learning from. Thank you. If there's a second microphone, we'll get Joe the Arc up. If there's not, we'll just do it myself. Is there a second mic? Is that a pain in the ass? Aye. Let's welcome the stage Joe the Arc of Minerva Waves, the Twisters. Joe also plays bass guitar in my other band, the Gyro Babies. This song's called For Everyone. Thank you for having me. Thank you, Dawn, for having us here. Thank you, Celine, with a beautiful salon. No, that's been brilliant so far. Conscious on the beat. This about never getting funding. When will Creative Scotland send us to Texas? Never fill out the form. I'm still throwing, I'm not accepting. PRS owes me money and it's driving me to bed. Not been this upset since the Christ. Just no rejection, let's get more. Related words from track, tick all the box. Just hyper-conscious, quick to gossip. As some abstract concepts, not a work from our sponsors. They aren't even born yet. The scene became toxic, now I'm handcuffed to a bomb. Weighing up the options of sorting my ammo football. Cost a pretty penny to shut the salon off by setting loose smoking fire with the coolest components. Settle simple, it's a simple, it's a simple, it's a bonus. Then it's fake accent. But you can speak my dialect. But put loose, it's a thing. Take host the most famous actor, stand-up comics and boys. They put a banger of a boot behind his pistol in the bonus. London says it, can't sell a Scotsman yet. Hires all our sales and dump a million gold. Sent us from invermested bears. Then is it censorship, ignorance or fear of the unknown? With the old firm in the premiership at the peak of their own. Cheerio, Canto, we get disowned by our own bits. The wrongness, the shortest, the least, and our own drummer was the Scottish cringe. He gave himself hatred diagnosis, threw an egg in the wind, and drew his infamous noses. This is Zodiac!
Excuse me, my forever underground. Celine Salon, I've been marked. This music has been Jackal Trade. This is Joy the Art. Thank you for making Cheers, guys.
Holy schmoly macaroni. That was so brilliant. And you know what? We've got more. But we need a little... I think everyone needs a drink, don't you? You all look like your tongues are going to lick the floor in a minute. Salivating with nothing. But anyway, let's give a big round of applause for Katherine Macfarlane. Keith Warwick. Maria Maz. Mark McGee. And Joe Dark, who we got the pleasure of. Close... One rule, I've actually locked you all in. You are not leaving this building because you're going to stick around. Joe is closing our show. We're so lucky. Everyone else that's coming on, it's going to be brilliant. If you miss it, you're a bloody twat, all right? Now put that in your pipe and smoke it. Thank you.